Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful portrait made of layered vector shapes. I provided for you a custom set of brushes that I downloaded from brusheasy.com. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Feel free to use a different set of brushes from their website or other websites if you like. Before we begin, make sure you click that subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. Open a focused high-resolution close-up of a face. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. This effect will look best if some of the face is in shadow. First, we'll make a displacement map, which makes the shapes look as if they're wrapping themselves around the contours of the face. To do this, make a copy of your subject by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Displacement maps are more effective when the subject's color is removed and when the subject is blurred. Press Ctrl or Command Shift U to desaturate its color. To blur it, go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. I'll blur it 4 pixels, however, you may want to use a different amount based on your photo's size and resolution. To check your photo's size and resolution, go to Image and Image Size. This photo is approximately 1400 pixels wide, 1584 pixels high, and 150 pixels per inch. Go to File and Save As. I like to save it to my desktop for quick access. Save it as a copy, which saves it as a separate document. Name it Displacement, and save it as a Photoshop PSD file. Then click Save. If you see this message, just click OK. Now that we saved it, we can delete the top layer. We can either drag it to the trash can or press the Delete key. Next, we'll make a selection of the head. Open the Quick Selection tool. If you're using CC 2018 or later, click the Select Subject button, which automatically detects the subject and creates a selection around it. If you're using an earlier version, drag the Quick Selection tool over the inside of your subject. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to your subject. Create a new layer below it by Ctrl-clicking or Command-clicking the New Layer icon. We'll fill the new layer with black, but before we do, check your foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Next, we'll convert our subject into a smart object to simplify our layers panel by integrating the layer mask with it. To do this, make your subject active and click the icon at the upper right. Click Convert to Smart Object. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Make a new layer below the copy by Ctrl clicking or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll be placing our first vector shape into this empty layer. Open your Brush tool and Brush Picker. After you install the brush set I provided into the Brush Presets folder, scroll down your list of brushes. You should see the new brush set at the bottom. Open the folder. They're all 2500 pixels in size, which is very huge, but don't worry, we'll resize them. Click on a brush and press Enter or Return. To reduce its size, make sure your Caps Lock key is off and press the left bracket key on your keyboard. Place it over an area where the shape works with the contours of the face. For example, I like the way the bottom of the shape follows the bottom of the chin. Once it's sized and positioned to your liking, click your mouse or pen to stamp the brush onto the face. Make the top face visible. We'll confine it to the inside of the shape below it by making the face into a clipping mask. To do this, hover your cursor between the face and the shape as you press and hold Alt or Option. When you see this icon, click your mouse or pen. This will indent the face, letting you know that it's now being clipped to the shape below it. Another way to clip it is to go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. There's even a third way, which is to press Alt-Ctrl-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. Double-click the shape, to open its layer style window, click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is linear burn, and if the color isn't black, click the box and pick black. The opacity is 35%, and the angle is 135 degrees. The amounts for the distance, spread, and size are relative to the size and resolution of your image. For this image, I'll make the distance 30 pixels, the spread 10%, and the size 25 pixels. The contour is linear. Make a copy of the shape and its clipped face by shift-clicking the face to make it active as well and pressing Ctrl or Command J. Make the shape copy active. We'll delete it and replace it with another vector brush. To do this, we'll select the boundaries of our visible document by pressing Ctrl or Command A, then press the Delete key to delete the brush inside the layer of the copy. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. So, at this point, the copy of the layer that contained the brush is now empty. We'll be placing a new brush into it. Open the brush set and click another brush. We can rotate the brush in any direction by dragging the wheel until the brush is oriented at the angle you want. Then, press Enter or Return. Another way to rotate it is to press the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. Resize it, and then position it and click. Repeat the same steps as you did before. Copy this shape with its clip face by shift-clicking the face to make it active as well and pressing Ctrl or Command J. As before, make the shape layer active and select the document. Then, delete the shape of this copy and deselect it. Pick another shape and rotate its angle if it works for the face. Reduce its size, position it, and click. Repeat the process until you've covered enough of the face with the shapes. I find that the results will look better when you leave some room between the shapes. Next, we'll place the shapes and the clipped faces into a folder. Scroll to the bottom and hide the bottom face layer. Make the bottom shape active. Scroll up and shift-click the top face to make all of the faces and shapes active. Press Ctrl or Command G. Ctrl-click or Command-click the face to make a selection of its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the folder. This will ensure that when we displace the shapes using the displacement map, they'll be confined within the layer mask. Open the folder and make the top shape active. Go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Make the horizontal and vertical scales 10, stretch to fit, and repeat edge pixels. When the window opens, navigate to your desktop. Click the PSD file that we named Displacement and click Open. Scroll down to the next shape and make it active. To repeat the displace effect, press Alt-Ctrl-F on Windows or Command-Ctrl-F on a Mac. Scroll to the next shape, make it active, and displace it. Repeat these steps for each of the shapes. Next, we'll make the perimeter of the face in shadow. Scroll back up, close the folder, and make a new layer. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft, round brush. We'll adjust its size in a moment. Make its hardness 0% and its opacity and flow both 100%. Adjust its size relative to how wide you want the shadow to be. Brush over the areas you want to be in shadow. If you want to darken the edges even more, reduce your brush's size and brush over those areas. Lastly, we'll increase the vibrancy of the face. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Vibrance. Drag the slider to the right. Whereas saturation increases the intensity of all colors simultaneously, vibrance increases more of the intensity of muted colors. Unlike saturation, vibrance protects skin tone colors from becoming too intense. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.